Hello, welcome back to my channel. My name's Catherine, if you didn't already know. Today I'm gonna be talking about like fitness, health, giving some tips on how I stay motivated, what I'm doing at the moment to keep fit and healthy, kind of a bit about my fitness journey itself, tips that I would find useful if I was new to fitness, didn't know much about it, and also if you want a bit more of an insight into my lifestyle and kind of what I'm doing, especially in lockdown because it's so difficult at the moment, then do keep on watching. And don't forget to subscribe down below, give it a thumbs up, and yeah, let's get into it. Day 3, I'm ready to do my workout. 3, day 1.
Some days things just take way too much of my energy. I look up and the whole room's spinning. You take my cares away. I can so overcomplicate. People tell me to medicate. Feel my blood running.
Before I start, I do want to throw a few disclaimers out there. The first one being, if you're someone who is triggered by anything to do with like weight loss, eating, even fitness, like triggers people, then please click out this video now. Don't watch it. Also, the tips I'm giving or what I'm talking about today, like I'm no expert in this field. I have no like qualifications in fitness or anything like that, but these are just things I do and things that just might help other people. So yeah, don't come for me. I'm just giving my personally what works for me. That's my little disclaimers. But yeah, other than that, if you don't fall into those categories, then please do watch the video till the end. So obviously being in lockdown makes it a lot more difficult to do anything, leave your house. You can't be going to the gym. You only have 1 hour a day to go and exercise. So for me, home workouts has been really, really important, and focusing on eating clean-ish and working out is what's helped me to not only stay in shape but also shed some pounds as well. Like, I over the last few weeks have shed a few pounds, nothing like extraordinary to scream and shout about, but I am on a journey to achieve like my perfect body. I try not to define myself by numbers, and I wouldn't recommend doing that, but I am looking towards kind of just perfecting my body, and I'm at the beginning of this journey, but lockdown has really helped me to take it seriously, because I was using other things as a distraction to kind of let things slip a little bit, or not focus on, number one, what I enjoy, but number two, what should be important. I think like health is so, so important, both physically and mentally, but I'm using this time to really, really focus on it. I'm not saying I'm perfect by any means, and I do have days where I literally couldn't think of anything worse and I don't want to work out, or I want to reach for something a bit more unhealthy. I have those days, trust me. But it's a good time, I personally think, to focus on it. So yeah, I'm going to talk about a bit more, but that's kind of what's been happening over the last few weeks. It's been a good 5-6 weeks now, lockdown, so you may as well focus on your health as much as you can. Yeah, that's what I've been doing, a little update, and I think I'm in a good place right now. I'm seeing results, I'm seeing changes, but I'm not at a point where I'm gonna talk about the numbers side of things just yet, because I'm nowhere near where I want to be, and I want to give it a bit more time. So I think that's a video for a few months down the line, possibly. If you want to see more of that, then do let me know. And I'm talking about like weight loss, but I'm not in a position where I want to talk about it fully in depth, but just know I'm on a journey right now. It's cool, and yeah. So when this lockdown thing started, I messaged my girl Mariah on Instagram, and I have mentioned her in a video before, but you might not have seen it. But basically, I hit her up and she put together a program for me. One of my top tips is you need to have a schedule and follow a program. And something like what I've been following from Mariah is so good, because it's handed to you on a plate. You have what you exercises to do each day. It doesn't have, like her program, she recommends working out like 3-4 times a week, which I think is so manageable. Even if you are working still, which I am, I'm still working full time. I'm still fitting in my workouts. 100% would recommend following a program. Mariah's plan is like tailored to you and what you want to achieve. So I have problem areas, most people do. So I said to her, look, I want to focus on my abs, I want to focus on my legs, because they're the things I need to, you know, get together. She provided me with a program, and it kind of gradually builds week on week, which is great, because if you're starting from scratch, like have no experience, or literally have let your fitness slip, maybe you're wanting to get back into it, it's perfect, because it builds week on week on week. And I've noticed changes in my body, like everything is a lot more tighter, everything is a lot more toned, and yeah, I've shed a few pounds, which is delightful. Get yourself a program, have a structure, and especially if you're like not working and you're literally just floating around all day, at least if you have you know that, oh, today I need to do my workout. Like, I'm going to wake up, I'm going to do my workout. And then you're kind of on a roll for the rest of the day. And I just think it's so important to have structure right now, more than ever. So, yeah, follow a program, have a schedule. Definitely, definitely. Personally, I find working out in the morning is better because it just gets it done. And from a scientific point, from a scientific perspective, is that the word? I don't know. From like science, the earlier you work out, the more calories you're going to burn throughout the day, because once you've done that workout, your body is then burning calories. And obviously, if you're looking to lose weight or even just to maintain weight, you need to be on at least like a balanced intake and outtake of calories, or a deficit, in order to lose weight. I think the earlier you work out, the better it is for your body, because then you're constantly, then you're burning for the rest of the day. You're more likely to be in a deficit by the end of the day, if that makes sense. I like getting my workouts done in the morning. I am a morning person. Like, I know some people aren't, but I'm just a morning person, so I like to get over and done with. Also, I like to work out on an empty stomach, because I find otherwise I start to feel sick, or like I just can't perform as good as I can on an empty stomach, so I'd rather just do it first thing in the morning. If you're doing it in the morning, and say you get up at like 10 or whatever, I mean, I don't, I get way earlier, but say for example you're not working, right, you get up at 9, 10, you do your workout, by the time you've done that it's like 11, half 11, by the time you've had your shower, freshened up, put some makeup on, got changed, whatever, whatever, it's pretty much lunchtime. So then you're only really going to have probably 2 meals that day, so it might help you again if you're looking to achieve a deficit. But it all just depends on like what your objectives are for your fitness journey, what you're looking to achieve. But if ultimately you're wanting to lose weight or you're wanting to tone up, then you are going to have to think about what you're putting in your body and trying to aim for a deficit. I'm not saying you should aim for a really, really big deficit, but if you're wanting to do it gradually, you are going to have to think about what you're putting inside your body. I don't really want to get into eating and food, because that's a whole nother area, and I myself haven't perfected that yet, so I don't want to preach about it, because I haven't got it down myself. But it's something you need to think about if you really, really are wanting to see results. Second tip that I would give is vary what you're doing, because otherwise you're just gonna get bored if you do the same thing day in, day out. It's not gonna work. The great thing about Mariah's plan is that you're focusing on different things every day. So one day you're gonna be doing like a leg circuit, for example, that you can go and do in your garden. The next day you're gonna be doing a short hit workout followed by some core exercises. Then the next day you might do another hit thing, but then you're going to do some leg toning. Like, you can vary it up, you can mix it up, you can keep yourself going. There was no 2 days in her plan over the 4 weeks that were the same, and that's great because it keeps you ticking over, it keeps you motivated, and it's a good way to stay on it. You don't just have to do these workouts, you can also go for a run, follow a yoga workout, do some meditation. Like, there's so many things you can do. Like, you don't just have to follow, as much as it's good to have a program, you don't have to do those things explicitly. You can go and do other things as well to keep yourself moving, even if it's just going for a walk, to be honest. Like, it's better to go for a walk for half an hour, get some fresh air, and then come back in, rather than doing nothing at all that day. So yeah, vary what you're doing, keep it mixed up. It doesn't have to be super long either. So with Mariah's program, it would take me probably the best part of an hour, but the HIIT part itself was no more than like 20-25 minutes, and then you'd just be toning, which it depends how many reps you're doing, how many rounds as to how long it takes. But if you're going to do it properly, yes, you probably need a good hour. But if you just wanted to do HIIT every day, you could do HIIT in 20 minutes and be done, and then go ahead and do everything else for the rest of your day. So there's so many options out there, so mix it up. That will keep you like ticking over, you're not going to get bored that way, and you're more likely to stick to the program. Once you're on it and you're in the swing of things, you are going to follow it and you are going to get results, like I promise you will. But it's just those initial first few days, weeks, getting used to it. You can't expect results overnight. Like, you've got to give it time and just trust in the process and it will happen for you. My third thing, which kind of ties into what I just said, but anyway, set realistic goals. Like, you're not gonna lose 10 kilograms in a week. Like, it's not gonna happen for you. So you've got to set yourself realistic targets and give the process time. When measuring how you're doing, like, weight is only one thing. Like, it's only one contributing factor. You've also got to look at how you're feeling, how your clothes fit, like how you're looking in the mirror. You'll just know yourself how you're doing. And yeah, it's good to like weigh yourself, see if you have lost like a few pounds or whatever, but ultimately that might dishearten you and make you like frustrated in a way, because your weight is going to fluctuate depending on like what you've eaten that day, or like your salt intake, or I don't know, other things. Also, if you're gaining muscle, like that could affect the numbers on the scales. So I would definitely say set realistic goals, but also don't just focus on numbers. Like, I've been there before and it's not good for you. You're not gonna have drastic results in the first 3 weeks. Like, you've got to give it time and trust in the process. Also, don't compare yourself to others, which is so difficult, and I do it myself. I find myself scrolling through Instagram, seeing these beautiful girls, seeing these amazing bodies, and thinking, why don't I look like that? Like, I want to be like her, or she looks so good, like, what's her secret? Blah, blah, blah. Focus on you, baby girl. Like, focus on what you're doing. Your time will come. And everyone's makeup is different. Like, someone might be so tiny, but they might have a really fast metabolism, so their body is going to be different to yours. Or someone might lose weight in a different area to you, so they might have a flat stomach, but then you might have smaller legs. Like, it just, everyone varies. We're all different, we're all made up differently. So really, really try not to compare yourself to others and focus on your journey, what you're doing, and your results. Don't be looking at other people, which again, easier said than done. But another tip, right, or just key thing, okay, it's gonna sound a bit weird, the number 21, right? Keep that number in your head, because it takes 21 days to break a habit, and I can vouch for that. Give yourself at least 21 days. I would say if you're looking at losing weight or starting a fitness journey, start on day one, see what the numbers are saying, but then give yourself 21 days before you even start analyzing the results, because it takes 21 days to break a habit. So if you're going to start your workouts, do it for 21 days and then see what the results are, and then give it another 21 days and see what the results are. Because I think 21 days is a solid period. And it's the same if you're trying to cut something out. So say you're like, you know what, I'm done with the chocolate. Cut it out for 21 days, and the first few, like 3-4 days, are going to be so difficult. And you're going to be craving, whether it's that sugary thing or those carbs or whatever it is. Get through those, push through those first 3-5 days. By the time you've done that, you'll then have done a week. Then you're like, oh, it's only 2 more weeks and I hit day 21. Give it another week. By the end of 14 days, you probably won't be craving those things as much. By the time you get to 21 days, you won't even be thinking about it. This is one of my like top tips. 21 days is key, and I do think you can break a habit, whether that's with food, drink, working out. You can do it in 21 days, trust. Give yourself 21 days, and by that point you won't even be thinking about it, because you'll be moving on to the next thing, because you'll be like, oh, I've conquered chocolate, now I'm gonna move on to biscuits. I've conquered biscuits, now I'm gonna move on to my fizzy drinks or whatever. I'm quite lucky in that I don't really crave those sort of things, but for me, things I've had to do it with is like, I had to do it with peanut butter, because I was getting to a point, and this sounds so stupid, but I was just craving it so much, and I couldn't control it, that I could eat it in moderation. So I had to just cut it out, and I haven't had it for probably like 2-3 months. I don't even think about it anymore, and that's a fact. So give it the 21 days, see if you can break a habit. Another good tip is to reward yourself. It might be that you think, okay, if I get through a week with doing my workouts and not touching these sugary foods, whatever, I'm then gonna reward myself with a glass of wine at the end of the week. It really depends on what your goals are as to what you should be rewarding yourself with. So if you are really, really trying to lose those pounds, then I would steer away from rewarding yourself with food or drink. But it also depends on your body and how much your body can and can't take. I reward myself with makeup and clothes, because if I'm doing a good job, I've completed my 4-week workout routine, I'm gonna buy myself a cute outfit, because not only do I look better and feel better, I'm then gonna need new clothes. I think focus on those rewards and then you're more likely to achieve your goals, because otherwise you're going to just be like, why am I working out? Like, I'm just doing this for the sake. Ultimately, what am I trying to achieve and what am I going to reward myself with at the end of it? Have rewards in the pipeline and work towards getting them. And say you've got like a target weight or whatever, you can think, if I hit that number, I'm gonna go buy that bag I want. Things like that. It's a lot of it is up here. So I'd say set rewards and treat yourself if you achieve your targets. Obviously, don't do what I do and buy a new outfit every week for no reason. Actually, buy things if you deserve it is another great tip. And that way you're more likely to go through the not so easy days, because you know there's something good at the end of it for you. One more thing that is quite key, I think it's worth investing in equipment. So especially if you're going to be working out from home or the gym, because you might want to use these things in the gym, but it's worth investing in equipment. They don't have to be super, super expensive, but it's worth getting those little things. So for example, I have a set of home weights. So I have like little dumbbells, and they're really good for like arm exercises, or if you're doing lunges or like Russian twists, anything like that, it's good to have weights. Key part of Mariah's plan was resistance bands, and I didn't have resistance bands before this, and now I do, and I literally love using them. So I'll get yourself some resistance bands, and they don't have to be super expensive. Like, I got a set of 5 from eBay and it was like £8. And also, one thing I love to use, which I think is a bit my opinion, but I use a waist trainer, and my waist is smaller than it was even 4 weeks ago. I think I would invest in one of them too. Again, it doesn't have to be super expensive. You can get them on Amazon for like £10, eBay £10. Just invest in the equipment and you'll see results quicker, I think. There's some of my top tips / suggestions / just what I do to stay fit and healthy, and how I'm losing a little bit / maintaining my weight at the moment. I want to do like a follow-up video in a couple of months, more focused on the weight loss section, but as I said, I haven't got it down yet, so I'm not going to preach about it or recommend things if it's not accurate or at a point that I'm comfortable talking about it. But just know that I'm on a journey too, and staying fit and healthy is a really, really important part of my life. Obviously at the moment it's really, really difficult, and it is hard to motivate yourself. And yes, like, I have bad days as much as the next person. Like, I have days where I really can't be asked to work out, but my program is literally there in front of me. I'm gonna put on my Ariana Grande Big Mix and I'm just gonna bloody do this 20-minute HIIT workout. And then by the time I've done it, I feel so much better for doing it. They're just like a few of my tips. And do be sure to check out Mariah. I'll leave her Instagram below, and hit her up if you want her to give you a personal program. Like, they're so good. And I have done a little, I don't know if I've, what point I'm gonna put it in the video, but I've been filming like bits and bobs of my workouts from the last 4 weeks. So hopefully you can see like a bit of my progress. I hope this was helpful in some way. I know it was kind of me just rambling for ages, and I don't know if any of that made sense. And as I said, I'm no expert in this field, but that's just what's been working for me, particularly at the moment. I think I do wanna do a video in a few months when I've got a more idea of my long-term results. Give me a thumbs up if you want to see that sort of, if you want an update in like a couple of months, because I'd be more than happy to talk about it once I got it a bit more nailed down. I hope it was somewhat useful. It might not be, and I'm sorry if it's not. But yeah, check out Mariah, check out her plan, and stay safe, stay well. Subscribe and thumbs up, and I'm sure I'll see you very soon with another video. Bye.